So once again, welcome back to online classes, students. Now here I am going to teach you Mrs. Witt's same chapter, chapter number 9, but the topic is different. What is that topic? Let's see. We are going to learn about capacity measurement or measurement of a capacity. Okay. See, student, I have drawn some objects which you can see on your board. Here I have drawn this what? Bucket. Bucket and the mug means which you use for bathing, and the glass which you use for drinking water and milk. And here is one bowl which is very small and one spoon. Now I am going to draw one more, that is cup. That is cup. I am going to draw one more object, that is cup. Okay. So see, students, this is your cup. Okay. Now, everyone, let's open page number 94. Those who have not opened yet, please, everyone, open your book. We are going to learn this page today. Here you can see the capacity of container is the quantity of a substance that the container can hold. It means, what is the meaning of this line? It means, what is the capacity of this container? How do you know? First of all, you should know how to measure this capacity. Okay. Suppose if here water is there inside of this bucket. If water is there inside of this bucket, so how to know? Then, first of all, you have to take out water and you have to fill this water with the help of some another object. Like this is a mug. You can take a mug and you can fill this bucket with the help of this mug. Suppose this is a bucket and you are filling it with one mug water and then another mug, then another mug. If you are filling this full bucket with the help of four mug of water, 5 mug of water or 6 mug of water. So whatever mug's quantity is there or numbers of mugs we are using, that is what capacity of this container. That is called capacity of this container. Suppose I have used 6 mugs for filling this full bucket. Okay, for filling this full bucket of water, I am using 6 mugs of water. So what is the capacity of this bucket? Did you understand what is the capacity of this bucket? The capacity of this bucket is 6 mugs of water. In the same way, suppose you want to fill this mug and you don't know what is the capacity of this mug. Then how do you know? You can take any glass and bowl and cup and spoon and you can fill it. Okay? And whatever object you are using, and you have to find out that how many times you are filling water or any other substances, you have to note that number of repetition which you are doing. Means if you are filling this mug with the help of 4 glasses of water. So what is the capacity of this mug? The capacity of this mug is 4 glasses of water. What is the capacity? The capacity is 4 glasses of water. Okay. So now if you want to fill this glass, okay, mug is clear. If you want to fill this glass, then how do you know? How do you know that how much water you can fill in this glass? You can use simply a bowl or a cup. You can take 4 cups of water and 2 cups of water and you can fill it. And suppose you don't have any cup, then you can take help of bowl and you can fill your glass with help of bowl. Suppose you are filling 4 bowls of water in this glass, it means what is the capacity of this glass? 4 bowls of water. And suppose you want to fill this bowl, then you have to use a very small object that is called water spoon. You can fill 2 spoons, 4 spoons, 6 spoons, and 8 spoons of water in this bowl, and you can see the capacity of this bowl is 4 spoons. we have to find out which container has maximum capacity of holding any substances or any material in it. Okay, so now see, first one is bound, which is very small, and the second one is mug, and the third one is glass. So you know it that comparison of these means bowl and glass, our mug can hold more water or more things in it. So which has maximum capacity? That is mug in this first group. Now let's see about second group. In second group you can see first one is spoon, okay, and what is the second one? Second one is kettle and the third one is cup. So cup and spoon, they both are very small. So what is the bigger one? Our bigger object is kettle, and kettle can fill more and more water in it. Okay, comparison these both objects. This much is clear to you students. Now let's see your third group. Third group is very much clear to you because it's very common sentence and very common pictures are given there. That is bucket. This bucket can hold more water comparison glass than bowl, because glass is also very small and bowl is also very small. Okay students, so now let's turn to page and let's see, this is our new chapter which I am not going to continue today students. Now we will see our next chapter in our next video. For today this much is enough, and you have to measure a bucket of water with the help of any mug which is there at your home. This is your house activity. This is your homework which I am going to give you today. Now everyone wonder what is your homework? After watching this video, you have to fill your any bucket which is there at your home with the help of this mug, and you have to note down in your rough copy activity of capacity, and then you have to note down bucket is equal to 4 mug of water or 6 mug of water, whatever your answer is. Okay, whatever answer you are getting, you have to write that, means your result. And in the same way, you have to take mug and you have to fill it with the help of glass. And you have to take glass and you have to fill it with the help of cup or bowl, you can use any. Like this, you have to do all activities your own, and you have to write it in your rough copy as an activity. Okay, and let's find out what result comes. I know you will get a very good result and you will enjoy it because it's very good activity of this chapter. Okay, students? So, your homework is clear, your chapter is clear, everything is clear. If you have any confusion, you can contact me in your live classes and you can ask me directly. Okay, I'm always ready.